G'day guys, Adam here. Thanks for tuning in again. Today we're looking at the Bushman 130 litre fridge that we've had fitted to our JK Caravan. Now we had this fridge fitted around about 12 months ago. We're gonna talk about the things that I really like about it and the things that just bug me just that little bit. So if you're in the market for a Bushman fridge, make sure you stick around.
Cool.
Just quickly a little bit about Bushman. So Bushman are an Australian owned business based down in Melbourne, Victoria. Still family run to this day, which is absolutely fantastic. So I always support, well, where I can, try to support Australian made. They used to do LPG stuff, moved into 12 volt stuff in the late 80s, early 90s when they sort of seen a bit of a gap in the market and then subsequently sort of moved into the Caravan type fridges. Now they have this Bushman DX range of fridges range in size from about 50 litres all the way up to about 190 litres. This model here that we've got here is the 130 litre fridge. And it retails for around about $1,600. You might be able to get it cheaper at a few other places, and comes with a 3-year warranty. All right, so you're probably wondering about power consumption. Now these fridges can be either run on 12 volt or 24 volt. Now they claim that they consume about 1.4 amps an hour at 25 degrees Celsius and the fridge set at 4 degrees. Now from my own independent testing, I haven't done a full 24 hour test cycle on them, but I have seen the compressor go up to about 4.7, 4.8 amps, which isn't too bad, especially for a 130 litre fridge. I don't think that's too bad. Put it this way, I've got two deep cycle batteries here. I've never got them below 12.5 volts, and that's in the peak of summer. All right, so why did we upgrade to the Bushman fridge? Now, the old fridge that was in here previously had died. It was an old three-way absorption type fridge, and it needed to be replaced. So we looked on the market to find out what was available, and we come across the Bushman, we come across the Dometic fridge, and there was a handful of others that we could choose from. It came down to basically being Bushman, being Australian owned, that's what we went with. It comes with a 3-year warranty. They retail for around about $1,600. I think we got ours for about $1,400 on special. So yeah, I think, look, they represent really good value. Anyway, let's show you around. Or actually quickly before we go into the fridge, these panels, so it comes with a black panel. You can actually change this if you want to something that suited your Caravan. And there's instructions in the actual manual to show you how to do this. And also the door is reversible. So if you didn't want the door to be hinged from the right hand side here, it goes through and talks you in the manual how to change it over. And basically this sticker here will cover the screw holes that are left by the handle, but it's literally probably like a 10 minute process. But I'm pretty sure you have to remove the fridge to do that. All right, so now we're into the fridge. So really comprehensive design. Up here in this top section up here, that's actually where the compressor is. So it takes up bugger all room. So in our old absorption type fridge, we went from 90 litres for the same size hole to 130 litres. So gaining 40 litres overnight has been absolutely game changing for us. We obviously run the Dometic CFF45 as our drinks fridge, our sole drinks fridge. And we use this solely for our food. It does have a little freezer at the top with a nice little magnetic lid so that it can just keeps the door open up here. I think it's about 6 or 7 liters in capacity. Good enough to stick some ice creams in there, frozen meat if you really need to and sort of stuff like that. That falls down. LED light, the light is ample enough for the fridge. Obviously if you pack it, then it's sort of obviously gonna create some dark areas, but it does its purpose. This is the manual adjustment for your thermostat. So one being warm and 7 being cold. We normally sit around the 5 to sort of 6 mark. We find that's pretty good. Although the only thing I will say is that when it gets hotter, we find that we've got to turn the fridge up a little bit colder. And vice versa, when it gets colder in temperature, our outdoor temperature, we've got to actually turn that back down. Otherwise it starts to get too cold. So one thing, if you are listening, Bushman, I would really love if there was a little digital display where you could actually set a target temperature, because with the knob, you're actually not sure what temperature you're actually setting to. But anyway, minor issue there. The other good thing is that all these shelves here, they're all adjustable, which is fantastic. I wish they'd actually done it on the door here. I wish they'd actually had these two trays that you could adjust, because this one at the top, whilst you can fit a bit of stuff in there, you're limited by the height. So probably a little upgrade if you're listening, Bushman. Good thing is, in the door here, you've got these pockets, so these dividers, so you can actually separate your drinks and they won't slide about. So if you've only got one bottle in there and you're driving around corners when you're traveling, it's not going to slide back and forth. You've got your crisper down the bottom, which is a nice big drawer. It's what, about 80 mil high or something. Stick your fruit and your veggies and all that sort of stuff down there. It does have a Perspex screen on top, so if something does drip down through, and hot tip, we've actually done that before, is that it's not going to actually soak all your vegetables and stuff. It's sort of going to stop it from running on there directly and then run down to the bottom of the fridge. All right, so with the handle, so as I said before, you can actually change sides if you wanted to, but you'll need to look in the instructions how to do that. I haven't done it. I've had no need to. But the handle itself, it's just simply just a squeeze type handle, and it's like a bit of a wedge, and it sits in there in this upper trim on top of the fridge, and just simply sort of latches shut. But we've done a fair bit of traveling around. We've probably done in excess of 5,000 or 6,000 Ks with this fridge, and we've never had it open. And we've gone over some fairly rough corrugations of roads, but yeah, it's never been a problem. All right, so there we have it, guys, my honest review of the Bushman 130 litre fridge. Now, I'm not paid to say this or sponsored by Bushman to give my opinion. This is 100% my own. I really do think it's a great fridge, and you can't go wrong, especially, you know, supporting Australian-owned business. Anyway, guys, if you haven't already and you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing. And for those guys that are returning subscribers, I really do appreciate your support. Anyway, guys, if you've got any comments or questions, leave them in the comments below and I will get to them. Anyway, guys, I'll catch you on the next one.